My editor, Ben Dodds, called me at 3 a.m. to give me the news. It was a woman this time, the third victim. Of all the reporters in the city, the Ripper picked me to write to. I knew that another mad letter to the city was soon to come, and I would run it on the front page of the Virtual Herald. I would let the world know the Ripper had killed again.
Hey, how you doing? I hope you haven't eaten yet, Quinlan.
Figured you'd get here sooner or later, Quinlan. You can't get enough of this story, can you?
I think everyone's had enough of this story, Magnata.
Cold Carl Stasiak. We gotta stop meeting like this.
Carl!
Sorry, Quinlan. What'd you say?
Is there any difference between this murder and the previous ones?
It was identical. Absolutely identical. It was a precision cut. A perfect line. And the way he empties out the body cavity. The way the organs are blown all around the room.
So it's the same killer?
Oh, for sure. I mean, the organs, they're completely cut to pieces. I've never seen anything like this in my life. It's amazing.
Want any clues to how it's done?
Don't ask me. You'd think I'd be used to seeing things like this by now. But I'm not. Whoever did this is beyond madness. It's pure evil.
Any progress in the investigation?
Who knows? Trying to get anything out of Magnata is next to impossible. Besides, if he does have a lead, he sure as hell never share it. He might lose his bounty if he does that.
Well, you've been working with Magnata for years, Carl. What's your hunch?
Well, something's bugging him. Who am I to talk? I'm having nightmares about this. I've been a forensic photographer for 22 years, and nothing's ever got to me like this. Now I can't sleep.
No, you just need a vacation, that's all.
Yeah, I hope you're right.
Any idea what weapon he's using?
Take a look at this mess. It has to be something big. A sword or a machete or something. Just can't cut through all that bone and muscle with the dagger. And the strength it would take to make a cut like that, he must be an enormous man. You know Vic Farley?
Yeah, the pathologist over at the Medicog.
He knows a lot more about murder weapons than I do. You should talk to him.
Don't go taking any souvenirs, Quinlan.
Same MO as the others?
You got it. Look around, you asshole. If anything, this is more gruesome than the other two. Hell of a lot more splatter.
Who's the victim?
Name's Stein. Renee Stein. Age 43. Book editor over at Knopf.
Any connection to the other two?
Well, let's see. Estevez was a programmer. Mendel or a dry cleaner. It'll take me 48 hours to run it down, but there's no connection here.
You have any clues?
No sign of forced entry, nothing's disturbed. Two sets of prints, hers and her mother's. The only thing not where it should be is this woman's insides.
What about witnesses? I mean, this guy must have been a bloody mess. Even if it's 3 o'clock in the morning, it's Greenwich Village. Somebody must have seen him.
As far as I know, he left us with one witness, and she's feeling a little fragmented at the moment. This guy is unfucking believable.
Why is her computer on, Magnata?
Well, it looks like she was in a public library node. But let me ask you a question. You got any mail lately? Maybe a little something from your pen pal?
He writes after the fact, not before. You should know that, Magnata. I wouldn't hold out on you.
Of course not. You've been very good about sharing what you know with me and several million other people. I should have busted you when you ran that first letter without letting us know about it. All right, Visiting hours over. There's nothing here you haven't seen at the other murder sites except a few extra gallons of body fluids.
Well, you shouldn't be touching anything, should you, Magnata?
I guess this case has me rattled.
Object scanned into database. Incoming WAC transmission.
Quinlan here. Hey, Catherine.
Hey, Jake. How are things there?
Well, it's very... red.
What, anything different this time?
Just the name, Catherine.
Listen, Jake, something's come up here.
Something about the Ripper?
Might be nothing. I don't know. Could be something big. Just wait for me at the newsroom and I'll let you know as soon as I find out.
Now talk to me. What's going on?
I have to go. Trust me.
Who's in charge here?
Well, after last night, I'd say that I am.
So all of a sudden, you don't have to explain yourself to me?
Look, if you don't hear from me in an hour, just go to my apartment and wait for me there. You can hang out with my crystals.
Catherine! Oh, shit. This shattered mug had something written on it. Salisbury. I wonder what that means. What's going on, Ben? Did Catherine get a break in the Ripper story?
I don't know, Jake. I thought you were the lead reporter in the story.
Well, so did I. Do you know what she's up to?
She's your assistant. You tell me. She ran out of here like the place was on fire.
Did another letter from the Ripper come in?
No, you know he doesn't send them to anybody but you.
Then I guess we're just gonna have to wait and see. Catherine and I met on the job. Despite reminding myself that mixing love and work can get messy, it didn't take long for it to become more than a professional relationship. She was supposed to be my assistant, but she was beginning to act like it was her story. I only hope that whatever lead she had, she wasn't in over her head.
Incoming WEC transmission. Source unknown.
Dear boss, have you seen my work this morning yet? Your stories make the cops seem so confident. None of you know how I do it. You never will. You shouldn't let your girlfriend do your work for you. She is close to me, and I'm not laughing. She's my next job. She gets it today. The story's all yours. Yours truly, Ripper.
Catherine.
Quinlan. Where are you going? Quinlan! Quinlan!
Usually it takes an hour to cross that part of Manhattan. I did it in 20 minutes, propelled by kicking myself in the ass for letting Catherine go out alone. I was scared as hell when I got there, but everything looked okay in her apartment. Until Catherine showed up, that is.
Catherine, what is going on here? Catherine, what is it? What is wrong? What happened? What? No, Catherine! Catherine! No! Catherine! Fuck! Catherine, please, Catherine! Fuck!
The good news was Catherine wasn't dead. The bad news was that she was in a coma deeper than anyone thought possible. The ever-helpful Detective Magnata had her brought to the Tribeca Center for Cyber Studies, also known as the Medicog. Meanwhile, I stopped off at the police station to see a few sources and try to retrieve Catherine's portable WAC. Hopefully, she'll have left me a message.
Hey, Quinlan. The Ripper strikes again. I guess we'll be seeing your work on the front page again. Another body and another byline.
You know, if you just catch this guy, Brandon, I could go back to writing the police blotter on page 12.
Sorry to hear about your partner. She was a nice girl. I liked her when she came around here.
She used to come down here?
Came down here all the time. She used to do your legwork.
Right. I can't do everything, can I? What about the library? That was the last place Stein was seen alive.
Standard operating procedures to copy all libraries. C-space files, that kind of stuff.
Well, how can I get my hands on what they found?
Hell, Quinlan, it's a public library. We just copied the files. Everything's still there.
I'll tell you, Lou, Magnata wasn't all too together at the murder site.
It's lucky for you.
No, I'm serious. There was this one strange thing.
Strange?
Yeah, I mean, if I didn't know any better, I'd say that he intentionally destroyed a piece of evidence.
It won't be the first time.
Well, he's done it before?
Yeah, he hides it, he destroys it, he withholds it, you name it.
And this is common knowledge.
Yeah, he's like king shit at a bounty collecting, and the chief gets a piece of it. I mean, what are you gonna do? You know how this place works.
Yeah. Forensics come up with anything yet?
Apparently, this pathologist over at the Metacog, he's come up with this theory. He thinks that the Ripper may have been using nanomachines to do it. This is the hottest lead we got.
Nanomachines?
Yeah.
You know, Lou, I think it's time I bribe a photographer. Where's Stasiak?
He's in Wyoming.
Oh, come on, Brandon. He's the only guy I haven't really talked to. You never know what he might have picked up on.
Yeah, well, that's the problem. He picked up on too much. I'm not kidding, would you? He went to Wyoming. The case was too much for him, and he took a leave of absence.
Stasiak. Cold Carl Stasiak.
Yeah. Get this. After the Stein murder, his wife calls and says Carl needed a little vacation. So that was it. He just got up. No goodbyes, no nothing. He didn't even give me a call.
Oh, Christ. What do you want?
Some respect, Spankowski. You know, you really shouldn't talk to me like that.
I shouldn't be talking to you at all, you goddamn leech. What do you want? Some of us gotta work for a living.
Right. I need the evidence in the Powell case.
No way, Quinlan. That could be my job.
Spanky, Spanky, Spanky. I own you. You're just gonna have to learn to live with it. Or, do you prefer I go down to the DA's office and tell them about a little evidence selling incident?
Jesus Christ, Quinlan. How long is this gonna go on, huh?
For the rest of your life. When I'm 80 years old, I'm gonna come in here and tell you to shine my shoes and you're gonna jump and do it, asshole. So why don't you just go and get the evidence in the Powell case and be quick about it, or I'm gonna make you kiss my ass. You stop moving like a fucking turtle? Where's Catherine's whack?
Whack?
Her computer, asshole. It's supposed to be here.
Magnata took it home. He's always taking evidence. The guy thinks he owns the place.
Something on another murder case. Hamilton Marford, eh? Does this have something to do with the Ripper?
Object scanned into database. Object scanned into database.
Looking for something, Quinlan?
No, I just need to ask a few questions.
Because if I find out you're going through my stuff,
I'll be glad to give you 72 hours on the tombs for tampering with an investigation.
Sling your shit at someone else, Magnata. It's not my fault you can't catch this guy.
Well, see.
Who is Wofford?
You were looking at my stuff. Did you think I was kidding about arresting you?
Well, it's not like you were hiding it. And we already ran the story in the Herald, so it's not really news to me. He was a cyber architect, right? See, what interests me, though, Magnon, is that you have a month-old file lying on your desk. Does it have something to do with the Ripper?
You're lucky I'm in a good mood today, Quinlan, because you come this close to finding out what it's like to be a human shish kebab rotating in one of our fine penal institutions. But you're way off on that.
What's with this place you sent Catherine to?
Well, it's the best of its kind for flatliners. And it's got a doctor named Burton who practically invented the field. She's a real ball breaker, though.
What do you got on the Powell case?
Look, just because you two played tiddlywinks in your birthday suits doesn't mean I'm going to open police files for you. For all I know, you're a suspect. I mean, you were the only one there.
Any new developments?
Yeah, the pile of bodies is getting bigger. I got crazies coming out the woodwork to confess. This Ripper's been spotted more times than Elvis. The mayor's on my ass. She wants to revoke my jurisdiction. I don't break this soon. Every cop in Manhattan be looking to get a piece of my bounty.
And you accuse me of getting rich off the Ripper. Are you aware that there's evidence missing in the Powell case?
What the hell are you talking about? There's no evidence missing.
Well, Catherine's whack, for example. Spankowski says you have it.
Well, then it's not missing, is it? Worry about your own business. Leave the police work to me.
Medicog, uh-huh, hold on. Medicog, uh-huh, hold on. Medicog, hold on. May I help you off with something?
Beg your pardon?
I said, can I help you? What'd you think I said?
Nothing. I'm looking for whoever's taking care of my girlfriend, Catherine Powell.
That would be Dr. Burton. Take the elevator to the second floor and make a right. If she's not there, go to ICU down the hall from there. Whatever you do, don't stand too close to her.
Why's that?
A little chilly.
Right. What can you tell me about this Dr. Burton?
She's the boss. I can't tell you anything. Not here, anyway.
Where's Farley?
In the basement. Take the elevator, follow the smoke.
Smoke?
Yeah. As you know, Farley's not the cleanest pathologist going. But we haven't had any complaints from his patients yet. And he's a soft touch for a smoke. If it wasn't for him, we'd never have any fun around here.
What are you doing here?
My name's Jake Quinlan. I'm a friend of Catherine's.
Quinlan?
How is Catherine? Is she going to be all right?
It doesn't look good. Her consciousness is deeply withdrawn.
Withdrawn? What's that mean?
It means her mental processes, her memory, the basic building blocks of her personality are inaccessible.
You mean she's in there, but you can't reach her?
That's a best-case scenario. We haven't yet diagnosed her psychic damage.
Well, is she going to be all right?
It doesn't look good. She's still in triage. We're going to just have to wait and see.
What are you doing for her?
I'm not doing anything for her as long as I'm standing here talking to you. Why don't you let me get back to work?
How did the Ripper do this?
It's hard to tell. She had some minor contusions on her head, nothing fatal, but you never know with head injuries. We won't know anything until we can get a data angel in there to do some investigating.
You can get a data angel into the consciousness of someone in a coma?
I'm not sending anyone in there until I've had a chance to fully map her psychic damage. Now, if you don't mind.
I mind. How did Catherine survive the attack?
Who knows? Maybe she fought him off. More likely, someone or something interrupted the Ripper before he could finish.
You here to check on Miss Powell?
Yeah. She looks pretty bad. Is there anything you can do for her?
She's in good hands. And she'll be in even better hands once Dr. Burton allows us to treat her.
Was there any hope for Catherine?
Not at the rate we're going. We haven't even established an etiology, let alone begun to treat it. We've downloaded megabytes of fragmented images, sensations, memories, but not much that helps us at this point.
Anything that might help ID her attacker?
Well, there's an image on one of the monitors in the lab that's displaying an image we retrieved from Catherine's short-term memory. Now, she saw the person who attacked her, but in this condition, her mind can only assemble an extremely distorted image of him or her.
Well, can we make it clear or maybe use a computer to fill it out?
No. Catherine's brain will have to produce the image. The only way to help Catherine is to restore the memories and personality the Ripper destroyed.
What are Dr. Burton's plans for treating her?
If she has something in mind, she hasn't told me about it. She's blocking everything except the most conservative treatments. We've started to assemble data on the patient's past. We're maintaining life support. That's it.
Well, so fucking what? I mean, she doesn't know what to do. I thought she was the best in her field.
She's one of the best. I don't know what it is about this case. There's something here she's not telling us.
Have the cops said anything?
No, not to me. Dr. Burton's the attending physician. Although I have noticed that scary-looking detective who checked Powell in keeps coming back. Him and Burton got into it yesterday.
They had a fight.
Oh, that's an understatement. They looked ready to kill each other. God knows what it was about.
I don't understand this. How can you rebuild Catherine's memory?
Well, the way we always do in a case like this. We assemble all the data we can about the patient's past. Life experiences, food she likes to eat, favorite movies, information on who her friends were. Then we upload all that back into the brain and hope that it triggers enough associative reactions to restore her memory.
What are the odds of this working?
Success rate's very high. I mean, we may not retrieve everything, but we should get around 90% or so.
What can I do to help restore that image of the Ripper?
Dig up everything you can about the Ripper, especially anything Catherine knew about the case. My course... None of it's going to be of any use until Dr. Burton allows us to send a data angel into her brain, but we'll worry about that later.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you think Catherine's notes on the Ripper will help restore her memory?
Those would be ideal. Except what you're showing me seems to be scrambled. And Dr. Burton still hasn't allowed anyone to deck into the patient's mind.
Right.
Looks like a holographic journal. Could be worth looking at.
options are pretty limited here. I tried direct cortex stimulation. It's risky, but there's a chance of it working.
It's too risky. We could lose her that way.
Well, we could try inserting data angels for a diagnostic. There's no risk in that.
I disagree. We've no idea what's left of her natural defenses. The trauma could have made them even harder to penetrate.
All right, look, then let's run the Norton Mapper program so we can obtain a gestalt profile and a cortical landscape. Then we know what we're dealing with.
You mean that hasn't been done yet? Why not?
Because I said so. I want her to stabilize before we introduce any kind of foreign code. Now, thanks for the consultation, but that's my decision.
How much more stable does she want, the woman? She's in a coma.
What's her problem? She won't do anything. Were we supposed to watch this patient die?
She's in charge. There's not much we can do. Our options are pretty limited here.
Hey, Vic. What's for lunch?
Hey, Quinlan.
They working you hard?
Working me like crazy these days.
Hey, is this Renee Stein?
Are you kidding? You were at the crime scene. You saw her inside splattered everywhere.
Yeah, I guess I did.
Yeah, this woman was married to her ripper. The businessman away on a trip for 3 weeks, he gets paranoid that his partner's putting it to her while he's gone, so he flies home early and shoots her to death. I mean, stuff like that, that's why I never got married, you know? I have my chances, though, you know?
Mm-hmm. Any luck figuring out the Ripper's weapon yet?
I'm completely stumped. I did every test on these stiffs. I mean, a computer cross-matched the wounds with every kind of blade imaginable? Nothing. I mean, it's like a cross between a Vegematic and a diamond cutter.
Come on, Vic. Something must have cut these people open.
Nothing these computers can find. Now, you don't believe me? Look at those control panels by the steps.
You hear about my partner?
Who's that?
Catherine Powell. She was attacked by the Ripper. Somehow she got away. She's upstairs in a coma. Dr. Burton's treating her.
Oh, your friend's in good hands. Burton's a good doctor. And if she gets stuck, she'll probably call in her secret weapon.
What's that?
A guy named Joey Falconetti.
Joey Falconetti. Who's Joey Falconetti?
Cyberspace expert that Burton uses on all our tough cases. Also known by his old C-Space handle, Falconetti. Get it? Crazy guy. Likes looking at the bodies. I'm surprised she hasn't called him in yet to look at your friend.
What do you mean?
Oh, he's the best there is on human-to-human decking. She usually calls him in on that kind of stuff, but not on the Ripper work.
Where can I find this Falconetti?
Difficult guy to find. Burton usually goes to a guy named Gamut Nelson. He passes the time at the Café Duchamp.
Duchamp, Vic.
Duchamp. Well, you can find him there.
Here's an isolation of just one of the organs from this body. The lines indicate the many cuts made from this organ. The sheer number of cuts isn't the only amazing thing, though. Watch this. All of those cuts happen simultaneously. Human hand can't move that fast. And it was like this for every organ in the body. I tapped the nerve memory of this victim and fed it into the simulator so that I could reenact the attack. $1 million piece of hardware. And look what it gives me.
Jesus. Looks like she swallowed a fucking grenade.
Notice the path of the cut. Not 1 centimeter offline. Like a seam was undone. Now, no human could have done this.
Because humans aren't strong enough?
It's not just strength, it's precision. He's cutting through skin, muscle, bone. No way this cut could be so neat. I'll tell you what else is weird. There are no traces of fabric in the wound.
Is Burton all she's cracked up to be?
Best in her field. She and I don't quite see eye to eye all the time, but she's good. No question about it.
So how come some people at the Medicog say she's dogging it on this one?
Because they don't know what they're talking about. She's never dogged anything in her life, so far as I know.
Sounds like you know her, Magnana.
Well, she'd have to have about 20 more pounds. 50 less IQ points for me to be interested.
Can you tell me anything about this guy named Falconetti?
Joey Falconetti. He's an overrated hacker, a two-time loser trying to hit the big time.
Really? Farley tells me he's an ace angel. In fact, I hear that Burton consults with him every time her back's up against the wall.
Well, he's got his hooks in her. But just cause that grifter bastard's a snake charmer doesn't make him an ace angel.
Is that a Quinton model whack you've got there?
Let me see.
I've been grepping for one of these for months. These are tough to find if you're not in the professions. What are you, a lawyer?
Reporter for the Herald.
Low end of the pay scale, eh?
Tell me about it.
You should work for yourself. There are thousands of ways to make money in the net. Believe me, I know.
Do you know Joey Falconetti?
Joey Falconetti. I haven't done business with that scoundrel in years. Talk about profiteering and net.
But do you know him?
Eddie and I owned part of an emoticon franchise. You know, one of those sea-spaced emotional counter zones? This was years ago. Legitimate business, you see, but... Eddie's a thief by nature. Robbed it blind. We had to sell out to some Palestinians in New Dallas. I haven't worked with Eddie since, but I keep an eye on him so he doesn't pilfer any of my holdings.
Do you know where I can find Falconetti?
You don't. The Falcon usually finds you and takes your money.
Well, lucky for me, I'm broke. A grave digger named Farley at the Medicog told me that you might be a link to finding him.
What's your interest? You out to kill him?
Well, it's not killing I had in mind.
Oh, well, somebody's gonna whack that bird one of these days. Eddie's consciousness is inside a few hundred terabytes of well space with his body safely hidden. I set Medicog up with a guy named Twig, lives out in Hoboken. He seems to always know where Eddie's at. Eddie usually presents himself with video. He likes to show off.
Hoboken. Mr. Nelson, what's your background with cyberspace?
Got some time. It would take a while. I've been decking with the global net since it went online. Present at the creation, you might say. That's why thugs like Falconetti disappoint me. Damn waste of talent.
Read your copy, Quinlan. You might nail this freak before the police do.
Just asking questions, seeing where the answers take me. Kind of slow in here.
Yeah, the Ripper's really put a damper on anonymous sex these days.
How about a beer?
Yeah, sure thing.
Why don't you try this one? It's called Viper Pills.
Goes down real smooth.
It's got some bite. On the house. Just nail the Ripper so that my customers can get drunk in public again, huh?
Okay. Cheers. What do you know about Gambit Nelson?
Gambit? Gambit's been coming in here for years. The man has seen it all. He can remember when the net went online. Back when there weren't any wells, and cyberspace was nothing but a bunch of isolated DBSs.
Must be a first-generation Decker.
He was one of the first C-Space entrepreneurs. He made a killing on the net. All of it's legal. It's weird, huh? You know, a good guy wins for once in a blue fucking moon.
Hey, Ben.
How's Catherine today?
No change.
Damn. This guy's the devil himself.
Ben, you know this cop, Magnata?
Typical new breed cop. One of those guys started arresting people in volume when cops started collecting bonuses. He's been more aggressive than most.
Yeah, that's common knowledge, but what's his story?
He's killed 6 people in the line of duty, some under questionable circumstances. He's bad news. I wouldn't mess with him, Quinlan.
Okay. Didn't we run anything on this Wofford murder?
Yep. Cyber architects. They lived near the old Central Park. Somebody put a bullet in Hamilton Wofford's head. Cops don't have a motive yet. They probably had a lot of money stashed away in that cottage, but there's no evidence of a robbery.
You ever hear of a Joey Falconetti, Ben?
No, the name sounds vaguely familiar, but I can't quite place it.
Catherine's address file. As good a place to find a clue as any. A computer with a deck port. You can never have too many of those.
Maximal dynamics operating system.
Exit cyberspace. Virtual Herald. Virtual Library.
I could use some help here. You're a human presence, I assume.
Everyone at a service desk is. The library doesn't use smart sprites for public interface. You don't read much, do you?
Did you see a woman named Renee Stein recently?
Records place her here, but she didn't check anything out, and I don't remember seeing her.
Have the cops talked to you?
They asked questions, but I couldn't tell them much. They copied all the files from the Victorian root directory and ordered us not to alter the file structures until the case is solved.
So any clues left from the day Stein was killed would still be here?
Guess so. I sure didn't take them.
A note with some call numbers on it. Could Renee Stein have left this here? Can you help me with this call number?
I'm sorry. This is not a valid call number. It appears Stein altered the reference matrix, but an unknown book was distributed. If you could unscramble the call number, I could help you. Wait, Quinlan. That's a valid call number. I'll get the book.
A book about the original Jack the Ripper. Can't be a coincidence. Renee Stein must have used this. But what does it mean? Laser game. Wonder what this inscription means. J. Dorset. Catherine's crystals. I always thought they were a little too neo-new agey for Catherine. Thank you.
Exit cyberspace. Catherine's well.
Detective Vincent Magnotta of the New York City Allied Police Force's Soho Corps. This is a restricted crime scene. You must leave the area immediately. This will be your only warning.
Notes on the Ripper case. My most important clue to learning what happened to her.
So, Biddy? Name's Quinlan. I'm a friend of Catherine Powell's.
I was wondering when you're gonna come by. I read about Catherine in the paper. Told her she was getting too close to that maniac.
Well, she never told me anything about you. What was she coming to see you about?
Take it easy, cowboy. Mine hasn't worked in years. Besides, Catherine didn't dig the training wheels. I was her source, and that was it.
What did you do for Catherine?
Like I do for anybody. I do what needs doing. I run a little B&E in the net, melt some ice, do a little handwriting analysis. Hey, I got my code for everything.
Well, selling smoke and melting ice don't go together. Strange qualifications for a shopkeeper.
Hey, in the net, everything isn't linked, Quinlan. The shop is the shop. In cyberspace, I can walk. I can run. I can fucking dance, baby!
What do you sell?
Whatever you need, Mr. Quinlan. Whatever you need. Just received a full shipment of Virginia Red Leaf, laced with Lucitril. Got a full range of smart drugs. You know, to catch the Ripper, you're gonna have to outthink him. And for what Catherine tells me, you can use chemical assistance.
What was she investigating?
She was trying to make a connection between the Ripper's murder victims.
So you're like a deck jock then. Are there any new innovations in cyberspace I should know about?
Well, notional engineering made some big advances, but the basic idea is still the same. Most of the angels you meet will be prepackaged product from TransTech or Rembus environment. Only the ace angels can design their own wings.
So there shouldn't be any surprises waiting for me?
I didn't say that. I mean, it's just that things will look familiar. Everybody you meet will either be a rendered image or a video image that looks awfully real. Of course, you only get video from the best hackers or from direct brain images.
What do you think about the ice, Soap?
Why are you so worried about ice?
I have a feeling it's going to get worse.
Your girlfriend had the same feeling. There's some really bizarre stuff on the net these days, ever since Rembus came up with that software with the Ice Maker program. You know, anybody with a deck can construct their own ice.
Bizarre stuff.
Oh, Oh, yeah. Attack dogs, giant rats, minefields, monkey balls, you name it. I can't tell you how to prepare for that world, brother. You's on your own.
Who goes there? Murderer! Murderer!
Of the English language, maybe. I'm just a journalist.
Beware you. I've got weapons here that can render you helpless.
Relax, old-timer. I'm not here to hurt anybody. I'm just after some information.
You, sir, stand in my domain. And the question is, who are you? Speak quickly.
I'm Jake Quinlan from the Virtual Herald.
Quinlan. Quinlan, I know that name. You're the one who speaks for the Ripper.
No, I don't speak for him. He just writes me letters and we print them. They're news. But who are you? I thought the owner of this house was dead.
One of them is my twin brother, Hammond. And he finished what he called the most fascinating project of his life. And then I found him shot dead right here in this room. And I thought he'd just fallen asleep.
What did the police tell you?
The police, bah! I'm sure they're in on it.
Do you think the police are in on your brother's murder?
It's obvious the way they were rooting around in Hamilton's work. Kept asking him for his well address. And threatened to lock me up if I didn't tell him. But they got nothing out of me. They took away cartons of his discs. But they won't find anything there. Hamilton was too smart for them to.
Was the cop a guy named Magnata?
Yeah. I should have vaporized him. You'll get nothing out of me.
I'm sure. Why don't you tell me about your brother's work?
You don't know? He was famous. Or he should have been. He built virtual worlds. Places from history and locations from the future. And you walk through them in cyberspace like walking through the corridors of time itself. And he was a genius like Leonardo.
What was he working on in the end?
As I told you, mum's the word, as he would say. And all I know, it was something involving stranger research than usual. And he came out of cyberspace one night and he told me he'd spent the day in an English music hall. And that's all I can remember.
Wow. Who was your brother working for?
What makes you so sure that I know?
We all confide in someone. A brother's a good place to start.
I don't know. Hamilton.
Hey, you all right?
He's dead.
I know, it's hard. But you must have some way to at least find out who he was working for.
My brother thought that he was protecting me, I suppose. Yeah. Of course, how's the killer supposed to know he didn't tell me everything? Besides, I'm trustworthy as the day is long. It's not like I'm gonna tell anyone about his secret hiding places.
Excuse me, what are you talking about? What about hiding places?
You know about the hiding places, huh? Well then, you know more than I do. Hamilton was like Leonardo. I tell you, with devices and concealments, components hidden in secret compartments all over the blasted house. And if I could just find them, I could plug them in and get his, well, address. But I don't know where the hell half of them are anymore. Maybe I should just clean the whole place out and move.
But in other words, I have to locate and unlock secret compartments in this cottage to find the address to Hamilton's cyberspace well?
Well, yeah, that's the idea. Doubt you're clever enough to do it, though. Doubt you can do it.
Another antique. The Woffords have quite a collection. I see these old guys don't get around to fixing things.
Cyberspace.
This is really strange. Books, pictures, and references to Victorian England. The old man must have been constructing a virtual Victorian environment at the time of his murder.
But why?
A scale model for what looks like a Victorian city. Apparently, the Woffords did most of their notional modeling in this well. The virtual tools of the trade were apparent. But what caught my eye was the scale model of a virtual city that was stored here.
You must be Jack Quinlan looking for the Falcon.
How do you know who I am?
Gambit called ahead. That's strange. Burton usually sends Dr. Cable whenever she's in trouble.
Oh, news travels fast.
I guess.
Tell me, Twig. Is Eddie as good as his rep?
Best I've ever seen, and I'm no amateur. He can deck for days straight and keep sharp. No paranoia, no mental fatigue, no loss of rationality. Of course, it doesn't hurt to have someone like me, cooking for him.
Cooking? You keep him drugged?
Hey, even an archangel like, the Falcon needs medication. Extended decking? Very hard on the dendrites, man. And the, tuchus. Lots of sitting.
I could imagine. Where's Falconetti?
Not a simple question. He's usually in two places at once. Tell Burton and Cable they gotta beg in person for Eddie's sake.
Don't play games with me, Circuit Head. Lives are at stake. See, I don't have time to trade one-liners with a goddamn glorified houseboy. You don't give me Falconetti in 5 seconds. I'm gonna email your address to Detective Magnata, and you won't be dancing with any shadows in a maximum security prison.
Don't blow your motherboard because Burton's getting lazy. That's her problem, not mine. Falcon is playing in one of his wells. The address is Circus Maximus. I'd suggest trying a different approach with him if you're planning on cooperation.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
My pleasure.
Monitoring Helen 1, Circus Maximus.
What's with the shadow?
Like him? He's a movement model for a C-space doppelganger I'm developing. If it all works out, he'll give me true multitasking capability. This is just practice, of course. The real thing will be in cyberspace.
Blood pressure, 120 over 70.
Excuse me. Sensors itch.
Respiration normal. Exit cyberspace. Falconetti Circus.
Looking for Falconetti? Well, I think you got him.
What the fuck is going on here?
It's a 40 gigabyte virtual environment. Made it myself. Pretty impressive, huh? Think of it like a game room, and you're my favorite toy. You're called the answer doll, and the idea is I throw a knife, and you answer a question.
Who?
The
fuck?
Sent you!
Farley! At the Medicog morgue!
Oh, shit! Claire sent you.
Ah! I have a friend in trouble. She needs help.
I love showing up Claire. First, you gotta show me what you're worth in cyberspace. I'm gonna work with you. I can see if you can handle yourself.
What are you talking about?
You shoot a bad guy, you get a point. You shoot a good guy, you lose. I had high score. You beat it and we'll talk.
Okay, I shoot good.
You and me back at the hacienda.
Now you wouldn't be lying to me now, would you, Eddie? Because I've been to your house, and you weren't there.
Well, just because you can't see me doesn't mean I'm not there. Talk to Twig. He'll be expecting you.
Monitoring Talon 1. Circus Maximus.
Play straight with me, Twig. I'm all played out. I want to see your boss in the flesh.
Relax. 58. He wired me on the Ethernet. He's on the other side of the door behind me. Once I open it, though,
monitoring telephone.
You're on your own.
Circus Maximus. Blood pressure, 120 over 70. Pulse, 58. Respiration, normal.
Hey, Twig, you lazy piece of shit! What kind of cheap-ass nootropics you feed me? I barely keep up with the data transfer in there. What if I lost that fucking contest? All right, hotshot, what do you want?
There's this detective named Magnata working the case. Won't tell me much.
You say Magnata? Christ, he's worse than a fucking criminal.
Sounds like you know him.
Know him? I know him. I know I'd like to blow his fucking brains out.
Well, how did an outlaw like you hook up with a respected doctor like Burton?
I mean, she didn't tell you? Baby has the hots for me. Has for years.
Does she? What's your take on the Ripper, Eddie?
Holy shit, I just realized you're the one he writes to. He's the only reason to read the rag. Fucking guy's incredible. He gets in there, paints a room in blood like Jackson Pollock on crack, and gets out with other trays. And that's buzzing about this psycho.
You sound like his number one fan.
I can't get the guy out of my head. His stealth, his tools. I've been collecting knives for 30 years. I don't have a clue what kind of blade he's using.
My friend and partner was attacked by the Ripper.
You're going through all this for a woman, I assume you're doing her. Do crazy shit for love, don't we?
Yeah. I'm beginning to think so. What's with all these knives?
Well, for one, I'd say they're sharp.
I didn't mean that.
Oh, I see. I collect knives. And there's this serial killer loose. Knives equal killer. Right? Gee, I heard you reporter types were smart, but heck, you're way over my head here.
Okay. Look, Eddie, why don't you help me out with Catherine?
Why should I risk my ass for you?
You could piss off your old enemy, Magnata.
Here's the deal. I've been in cyberspace for 80 hours. I got a collect from two bookies, eat a big steak, and I'm dying for some real food, and sweat these cheap-ass nootropics out of my system. It'll take a couple hours. I'll meet you at the ICU later. Then we'll see what a genius can do about your babe.
Great. I'll see you there. I was beginning to think I was in a bad mystery novel where everyone did it. It was also beginning to look like I didn't know Catherine as well as I thought I did. The private sources, the research she'd been up to, and the secret meeting with the Ripper. And she never told me a thing.
Doctor's available, ma'am.
Hold one moment, please. Hi, Quinlan.
No word on your squeeze. Burton's keeping all the paperwork to herself for some reason.
The Falconetti show up?
Yep. As a matter of fact, they should start fighting right about now. They don't usually take this long. I just wish they'd do it and get it over with. Hey, how come you never came back to see me on my break?
I'm here to see my girlfriend, Viv. She's in a coma, remember?
What do you know? A guy who's faithful.
Mm-hmm.
Go on, run off and see your girlfriend. See if I care. Call me if she croaks.
I heard that.
I said no, Joey.
Heard that before. No, Joey, no, Joey, no.
I don't want you here. I don't want you in this hospital.
You gotta let me do my thing. I can find out what happened to this babe. Besides, you always call me in on these. You don't this time. It's gonna look bad.
No kidding. You think it's an accident that Magnata brought her here?
Fuck Magnata! Should've clipped his wings years ago. He's gonna try to pin this whole fucking thing on me.
Or me. Which is why we do it my way, and I say no.
No what?
Yo, Quinlan! Tell Dr. Burton here to let me save your friend.
What's Falconetti talking about?
It doesn't matter. I'm not letting him do the procedure.
How long have you all known each other?
Look, Quinlan, it's personal. It has nothing to do with Pal's case, believe me.
What thing are you talking about, Eddie?
Decking into this chick's consciousness. I can access her brain just like I can a computer.
Well, what good is that? She's in a coma.
She's not brain dead. Her essence, her personality, whatever. It's all still in there. I mean, if I could just get at it, there's a chance I could even rebuild her memory.
It's not that simple. For one thing, you don't know for a fact how much of her essence she's retained. For another, you have psychological ice to deal with. You'd be fighting her mind. The strain could kill her.
You knew Magnata years ago.
He was a very different man then. He used to be a scumbag. Now, he's a scumbag with a badge.
Why would he try to pin the murders on you?
He's gotta pin it on somebody to make a buck. I guess he thinks I'm an easy target.
Is your method dangerous?
Were you kidding? Of course it's dangerous. We're not talking about accounting databases here. Decking into an organism's a lot harder than linking into a machine. You can't be overriding shit. You gotta watch where you're digging around. Emotions, memories, potentially very damaging. It's worth the risk, though.
Well, how do you figure?
I can rebuild her memory. I can make that image so real, you'll think it's breathing. You'll be able to stare the killer right in the eye.
Well, that would save Catherine and anybody else the Ripper had on his list. I mean, what's the real reason for preventing Falconetti from doing this, Burton?
Do I detect a little Magnata in the reporter's line of questioning? Do any damn thing you want. I'm going to the gym.
Good. Starting to look a little flanky there, Claire. Tighten up those bonds, baby. You ready?
What do you mean? We're gonna deck to Catherine's brain now?
Damn straight. You can really get to know your girlfriend now. Here's the deal. With both of us being in there, it's gonna take everything I've got to maintain a link between us, to isolate a pathway to whatever's left of her consciousness. If her brain starts throwing ice at us, you're gonna have to fight it. Think you can handle that?
I think I can.
Come on, Quinlan, we gonna do this or not? Use your decking unit on the computer, we can help your girlfriend.
Personal background as I can. You need to bring her up to speed on what she knew when she was attacked. Use the information about the Ripper you think she may have known. That'll help her rebuild her memory. Right now, she's not even verbal. The more information she gets from you and Burton, the more she'll remember, the more she'll be able to tell us.
She looks so real.
That's because everything you're seeing right now is streaming directly from her brain, unmediated by any software. That's her. As her own mind's eye conceives herself. Be prepared. When you get close to her, you're gonna change. You'll look just as real.
Bad for a first-timer. Was it good for you, too?
You kicked ass in there.
No shit, Sherlock. Now, if you'll excuse me, I got about a month of girly mags to catch up on.
Excuse me.
Hey! What are you doing here? You're not supposed to be here. This place is off limits to unauthorized personnel.
I'm Jake Quinlan from the Virtual Herald. Who are you?
I'm Bob Epples, the new pathologist, and I'm not to speak with you, Mr. Quinlan.
Well, what are you talking about? Where is Farley?
Mr. Farley is no longer employed here. He was let go.
He was fired. Where is Farley?
I have no idea where Mr. Farley is. But from what I've heard about him, I suggest you look for him in a restaurant. One that specializes in fatty cuisine. Do-do-do.
Why was Farley fired?
I didn't ask, but I got the feeling that Mr. Farley liked to talk a little too much, and I don't plan on making the same mistake, so please leave, Mr. Quinlan, before someone sees me talking with you. My boss finds out you're back, I'll be fired. Now get out!
What do you got? A cotton back there, Quinlan?
Here's my stuff.
Going into interrogation, Brannan. You know, little police work.
How's the coffee, Sarge?
Nice and hot.
Guys got balls so big they collect the gum on the floor. They do, they drag. Soho Precinct, Sergeant Brannan speaking. What's your problem?
Chekhov, I'm talking to you.
Right. Don't call him anymore.
Any new developments, Lou?
Sure, but nothing's getting us closer to the Ripper.
Like what?
Like earlier today, Magnata pulled two cops who've been on the Ripper case since the beginning, replaced them with new guys. Now that's bound to set the investigation back.
That doesn't make any sense.
That's what I say. I know. Tell me about it.
What's the buzz in the precinct on Falconetti?
Word is that outlaw's mixed up in this somehow. Magnata's pulled the hard copies on all of Falconetti's records, and he's had passwords put on computer files. There must be something there he's looking for.
Or maybe something he's trying to hide. Lou, what do you know about the Hamilton-Wofford murder?
I haven't followed the case. I don't know much about the guy except that he did some work for the precinct some years ago.
What kind of work?
Magnata hired him, I don't know, 5-6 years back to build a virtual target range for the cadet cyberspace training.
So Magnata knew him?
Yeah, that's probably why he took the case on, even though he's got his hands full with the Ripper. Not now, Quinlan. It's not a good time.
Thank you.
I'm not a fucking dealer, man. Those were legal dosages for my personal use. I'm holding down like four jobs at once, man. I need the fucking mental clarity, okay?
See how much clarity you have when I'm done with you. Those senior citizens you sold that Lucidril B to had severe arterial hypertension. Five of them popped blood vessels in their heads. Now talk, fuckhead.
What are you looking at?
Enough, okay? I sold those fossils some Lucid B. Not my fault they had blowouts. I mean, what are you making a big deal out of this for? It's not like they weren't ready for the big sleep.
It's touching to see you feel so deeply. They say underneath the skin of every junkie runs the blood of a poet. I wouldn't know. I'm just a cop who loves his job. No performance now, mother. I'm in rehearsal.
Files are locked. Looks like I need some kind of ID card to open them. Vince Magnata's personnel file. Could make for interesting reading. Thank you. Catherine never was any good with numbers. Pretty clever. A neat little place to store surveillance bugs.
So this is what you're gonna do? Beat the shit out of me? You like beating up girls?
No girls, sweetheart.
You were a real man, that'd be a compliment.
Ooh, cut me. Let me tell you something. I'll be the worst customer you ever had.
Fuck you.
You think I got time to be polite? I could break every bone in your body.
What do you want?
What do I want?
What do you want? Never been roughed up like this before.
Yeah? Wow. Count your blessings. Ooh, here comes a blessing now.
Magnata will never even notice the bug is there.
Metacog, hold on. Hey, Jake. Saw your story on the last murder. Look, you know I was just kidding about your squeeze croaking and all, right?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, God, man, it must have been awful. And I'll tell you something else. Magnata's been looking for you. I mean, I figured you should know, because he is not the kind of guy I would want looking for me. He isn't even the kind of guy I'd want to look at me.
Is he here now?
He just left. Coast is clear.
Thanks, Viv. I appreciate it.
Not enough you don't. But you're welcome just the same.
Locked. Damn. How am I supposed to open this? What's a cyber surgeon need with an anatomy model? Well, that fits in there nicely. A copy of Advanced Notional Modeling. Dr. Burton's prescription pad.
Object scanned into database.
I expect you in my office tomorrow with your work completed, Mr. Wendell. Good day, Mr. Wendell. Yes?
Excuse me, Professor Beck. I'm a reporter for the Virtual Herald. You have a few minutes?
That's how many I have exactly, a few. What can I do for you?
Do you remember a student of yours named Claire Burton?
The only student I ever encouraged to leave school. Why do you ask?
You advised a student to leave school?
Frankly, this place had nothing to offer her. It was my feeling that it could have even restricted her development. But I repeat, why do you ask?
Well, she's taking care of a friend of mine. And some of her colleagues think that her treatment is a bit unorthodox.
I have no doubt it is. She wouldn't look at things the way most surgeons do. It's what makes her so creative, so innovative.
She seems a bit weird about it.
Oh, she's quirky, all right. I certainly remember that about her. Some very unusual predilections indeed, but that's often a mark of genius. Unless Claire has changed drastically in the years since I've seen her, you have no need for concern.
Well, thanks. Was a man named Joey Falconetti a student of yours?
No, but I remember him well. He was an astonishing cyber surfer. But he was more interested in pretty assistants than in any genuine original thought.
Did he have a, affiliation with Claire Burke?
By affiliation, I assume you mean did she have an affair with him? I couldn't say. She may well have found his air of danger sexually appealing, and she was certainly aggressive intellectually. I'm sure she went after him to challenge his skills, see if she could prove herself superior. Who knows? The web runners may even have been her idea.
The what?
The web runners. It was a gaming club of some sort. It was cutting edge. Claire and Falconetti were among the founding members. In fact, when she left school, Claire seemed to do little else. She virtually disappeared.
Does this club still exist? I mean, where can I find them?
Oh, they're like children with a secret clubhouse. All I know is that they post notice of their meetings on the bulletin board out in the hallway. They usually encode the information, however, hiding it amongst the flyers and announcements posted there. Something about arranging those flyers in the proper order will form a sentence revealing where and when the runners plan to meet.
Do you know anything about a policeman named Vince Magnata?
Claire used to mention him. Apparently, he had quite a temper. I'm sorry. I've told you everything I know about Claire Burton. You're taking time that belongs to my current student.
So the location of the webrunner's loft is hidden somewhere on this board. Got it. I hope the web runners don't mind a visitor.
Indian and I had Goldilocks by the throat.
This won't take too long, honey. I just need to ask you a few questions.
Make an appointment with my secretary.
I'm going to tell you what I've been going through lately. Hop along. I've been playing tag with the serial killer and ruining my shine by walking through his victim's guts. My girlfriend's in a coma, and the next time the Ripper kills, it could possibly be yours truly. So fuck your cartoons!
Okay.
Fine. Now, let's talk. A woman named Claire Burton. Used to be a runner. Do you know her?
Yeah, I know her. I mean, I don't know her. I know who she is or who she was. She was one of the first. A proto-runner. We care about our history, man. You've got to know where you've been to know where you're going.
Wow. It's interesting. So, what do you know about her?
I just know who she is. Seen her pictures hanging on the walls in here. You can see them yourself.
Do you know anything about a guy named Falconetti?
Every runner's heard of the Falcon. He's a legend on heels. Before he was a runner, he fracked with a gang called Aero 33.
Falconetti was 33. Was he part of this TRW thing?
Story is, he masterminded it. Core overwrite. Took out the credit record of every adult on the East Coast. Cops never got him. They say he's still out there, waiting to strike again.
I bet. Ever hear of Vince Magnata?
Sounds familiar. You'd have to grep the runner's archive well to see if that guy means anything.
How can I access the runner's archive?
Never actually been there myself. It's for senior runners only. I know the address. It's at Anachrony Station. You're on your own with the ice, though. It's a bitch.
Okay. Thanks.
Exit cyberspace. Webrunners Archive. Thank you.
Cyberspace traveler. Strengths include graphical user interface development in multi-dimensional hyperplanes and first-person post-arcade shooters. Handle: Churchill. Games author: Hostage Golf, Slipstream, and Hip Hop Mafia. Left web runners after marriage to Joey Falconetti ended in divorce 15 years ago, and the latter was sentenced to prison. Burton Falconetti marriage ceremony of note. Due to disruption by another web runner, Vincent Magnotta, who claimed to be in love with Burton. Josie Dorset, 3-year member, an extraordinary hacker and decker, but one known not to flaunt her cyberspace talents in a pretentious fashion. Handle: Disraeli, games author, alien mothers, virtual twister, and beach party cryonics. Graduate research thesis on the effects of extended decking brought her national acclaim in the cyberspace community. An enthusiastic gamer, she died under very mysterious circumstances. The Josie Dorset case is still unsolved to date. Josie Dorset left behind an ex-husband and a teenage daughter. Victor Estevez, 5-year member. A highly skilled programmer, decker, and designer. Best known for his controversial past, followed by his personal religious conversion. Handle: Albert. Games author. Sim Team Runaway Exploitation. Headhunter. New Testament Interactive Volume 1. Sim Noah and Genesis. The Ultimate God Game. Reputed to be the web runner's programmer extraordinaire. Expert in low-level supercomputer programming. Author of several controversial underground games that continue to draw a large cult following. Following a personal religious conversion, Estevez became a senior programmer for Revelation Incorporated, where he is designing and writing a new line of religious interactive adventures. Joey Falconetti, also known as Falconetti, 8-year member, founding father, an angel, an ace cracker, a master of cyberspace. Handle: Beaverbrook. Games author: Collateral Damage 2020, Humvee, Logic Bomb, and Dwarf Toss. Left runners 15 years ago when convicted of murder in the first degree. Conviction was overturned 2 years later when it was discovered that a police officer had falsified evidence leading to the conviction. The police officer suspected, but never convicted of mishandling the evidence, was Vincent Magnotta, a former web runner. Stephanie Jordan, 5-year member, decker of modest ability, no significant strengths or specialties. Handle: Victoria, games author, trophy wife, and streptococcus. Most notable for the company she kept, Jordan engaged in lengthy multiplayer gaming sessions with Falconetti, Magnotta, and Burton, played no role in the deadly events that tore the formidable trio apart. Left the runners due to unknown circumstances. Vincent Magnata, 8-year member, Archangel, Ace Cracker, a master of cyberspace whose talents were exceeded only by Joey Falconetti. Handle, Sir Duke. Games alternate, Designer Jeans, Hebrew Vice, Copadelphia, and Pistol Party. Betrayed Runner's credo that information shall be free by joining the data fascists at the Soho precinct of the United Police Forces. Explosive romantic triangle with members Claire Burton and Joey Falconetti culminated with Magnata's implicating Falconetti in a murder and the three of them leaving the Web Runners. Sam Mendler, 4-year member, a decker of above average ability. Strength included interface design and applied gaming theory. Handle, Baffled. Games author, Wolfenator, Horrorbusters, and President Satan. Mendler's game Wolfenator was a national bestseller. Known for his strong game design skills, Mendler followed up his smash hit with the highly controversial President Satan. Suddenly a target for an angry public and a hungry international media, Mendler left the Web Runners and retired from the gaming community. Years later, he opened a successful dry cleaning business in the Bowery. Renee Stein, 2-year member, known more as a plot writer than a decker. Strengths included character development, plot tree branching, and artificial personality construction. Handle, Salisbury. Games author, The Heat of Hate City and Bloodnet 3000. Talented writer, designer, and game scenario builder. Left the Web Runners to pursue a career as a hypertext novelist. She authored 3 acclaimed interactive novels before taking a position at Knopf as a senior editor. Claire Lynn Burton, 5-year member, gifted cyberspace traveler. Strengths include graphical user interface development in multi-dimensional hyperplanes and first-person post-arcade shooters. Handle, Churchill. Games author, Hostage Golf, Slipstream, and Hip Hop Mafia. Left Web Runners after marriage to Joey Falconetti ended in divorce 15 years ago, and the latter was sentenced to prison. Burton Falconetti marriage ceremony of note, due to disruption by another Web Runner, Vincent Magnata, who claimed to be in love with Burton.
WAC transmission.
Mr. Quinlan, this is Stephanie Jordan. I was a member of the Web Runners with Claire, Eddie, and Magnata. Professor Beck emailed me, told me you were asking questions about the Ripper.
You know something about it?
I'm in terrible danger. Meet me at the Web Runners loft. Hurry. There's something in cyberspace I want to show you. If I can find it, it will change everything you know about the Ripper. Hurry!
Bad weather had closed the skyways, forcing me to fight the street-level gridlock. It took me over 2 hours to get there. By the time I arrived at the Web Runners loft, I was too late. The Ripper had struck again, Jordan was dead, and Magnata had her body removed.
The cops just took the body. God, it was terrible, man. I was all decked in, and I was doing the OK Corral. And I was shooting the hell out of the Clintons, and I felt all of this stuff hit me, and dude, I'm not even thinking about it, because I figure it's Doc Holliday blowing Frank McLowry open. McLowry's still alive, and shooting Morgan, so I know something's wrong. So I pause the program, and take my goggles off. Was just all cut up with her eyes open and looking at me. And fuck, I didn't do this shit, man. I didn't even see anybody leaving. I'm gonna be sick, man.
No. You take it easy, cowgirl. You take it easy. Nobody suspects you of anything. It's all gonna be over soon, right?
Incoming WAC transmission.
Hooray, Quinlan. I never thought I'd see you miss a